We're in Mongolia fishing for taimen. We've had some luck catching lennok, a species of fish that the taimen feed on, but we want hucho taimen. The river wolf, as locals say. Sok, one of the wranglers, suggested a nearby tributary that might be holding some large ones.
I mean, the goal really is to get as far back from anybody so that we can be where these fish are untouched.
Oh, look at this, guys. Oh, yeah. This looks good, fellas.
We're trying to throw the biggest possible patterns on our fly rods that we can to try and represent what they eat. And that's the big bait in the river, the lennok, mice, rodents, anything like that.
It's the right color to mimic what these lennok look like. They do get bigger than this, but I think this is gonna turn some heads.
All right, this is going down. I'm gonna get a taimen out of here. I'm not sure if I can cast this fly. It's absolutely humongous.
Oh, come on.
We figured the best thing to do is like try to hit it in all three zones. So Jay was on top surface, fishing a floating line with a big mouse on top of it. Chris stepped in with an intermediate line that goes maybe like 3 feet under the water. And then I'm just doing the cleanup crew, and I've got a T14 really heavy sink tip line trying to dredge the bottom. There he is. Got him. Fish on. Yeah, buddy. Oh, that's a nice fish. They pull so hard. Oh my gosh. Oh man, I'm gonna need some help.
I got it. I'll be your tailor. Got him.
Nice.
Nice one, Thad.
Ah, yeah.
You got it on that fly too.
I did, dude.
Nice. I didn't know you had to sink some. Oh man.
Oh yeah, look at that thing. Oh, it was a long journey to get here. And this tributary that the Sok put us out is definitely worth it to me. Good job. Yeah, thumbs up, buddy, yeah.
That's awesome.
Just being able to get that taimen, that's just one of the greatest feelings you can ever have. You know, big fish that put up a big fight, and just that whole experience of everything coming together, it was absolutely fantastic. All right. Thank you. Worth every mile.
Some of the other guys have caught some small ones, but I want a big one.
That's why I came to Mongolia. I want a big taimen. I want something that's humongous. I want something that's 60 inches.
This isn't river monsters. I'm not saying that people have died from these fish, but if you were to throw Paris Hilton's chihuahua out into the river and have it swim back to shore, one of these taimen would crush it. These fish would eat anything. I'd throw a chicken up there to eat the chicken. That's why we're throwing these huge flies.
Oh, fish.
Got him.
Got him.
Got him.
I saw him. I saw it.
Got him.
Right, I'm gonna take you down to this rock bar. You'll be able to hop out here.
Oh, dude, this is a big one.
It's deep here. Oh, Brian, I'm not sure how we're gonna land this thing here. Hey, it's just gonna get deeper if you go that way, you know that?
Uh-oh,
it's too deep. So I was filming over Chris's shoulder, and I could see Brandon, the cameraman, coming across the river. It gets a little deep, he starts going deeper and deeper. If you fill up your waders with water, that's like a lead weight bringing you to the bottom of the river. There's a very good chance that you'll drown. We're gonna have to do a rescue mission here.
Let's stay up, stay up.
Go get him.
Hurry up, Brian.
Don't drown your waders, just stand up. I got you, bud. You got it?
Thank you.
You're welcome, dude. Holy crap. All right, I'll get us to shore. In the blink of an eye, it goes from Chris hooking this massive taimen to almost losing one of our crew members.
You all right?
Yeah.
That was insane, man.
He was rolling the whole time as I was coming to pick him up.
Nice rescue, Brian.
I got to him in the nick of time. And he's super fortunate that raft was as close as it was to where it all went down.
Oh man, I'm glad I was there. You weren't getting any shallower, that's for sure.
That was not a moment too soon.
Yeah, that was not gonna be good. That could have gotten ugly.
I got a big fish on.
This thing's ready. Coming in hot.
Look at how awesome that thing is. That's a good one.
Oh my gosh, yeah, I got him.
Look at that thing.
It's pretty awesome when these fish hammer the fly that you're stripping.
So many casts, so many miles we float down this river. This fish did not come easy. This was 10,000 casts to catch this thing. This was ridiculous.
Such a good feeling to finally catch these fish.
I'm happy, I'm stoked. This is why we traveled all the way here. Hell yeah. Long time coming.
Well, we got a cameraman that just about went all the way down the river. We need to go down there and check on him and see what we can do to help him out and get him warmed up.
And literally, you're like an angel from heaven. I just reached out. You're right there.
Are those pants got on wet? I've got a pair of wools in my backpack that we can throw on.
Well, I saw the fish. I'm like, I gotta get.
It's dedication is what it is.
Yeah. The fish, and then all of a sudden, it got deeper and deeper.
This guy deserves a bonus right there. That's a bonus.
After warming up our cameraman and reuniting Sock with the rest of the wranglers, we're off to fish the final stretch of river. So this is our last chance to catch Taimen.
You're casting especially nice today.
Looks good, Dad.
Yeah, boy.
We're getting down in the zone right here. Come on, see what you got. I know you're in there.
You gotta throw some meat at him. And what I'm trying, I'm calling it the Terminator rat. Every time you're stripping the line or twitching that rat, you have to be ready for a fish to come up because it could happen at any time.
Big one, big Taimen.
Got him, got him. That's a big one.
Roll over here, roll up on this bar.
Holy crap, my heart is pounding out of my chest.
It is huge.
Come on, baby, come on. Please don't fail me.
This current is ripping. Holy crap.
I'm trying to keep my balance, trying to fight this fish at the same time. All I could think of is I'm gonna lose this fish.
Man, that's a big one. Brian, bring his head over here.
Grab his tail.
Yes, sir. Yeah.
Holy.
On top water. Yeah.
Look at that.
Oh man,
dude, that
just
thing
stepped
is
it up a notch.
When I finally held this thing and was able to see the size of it, it was just total elation. I mean, this is the biggest Taimen that I've ever caught.
That's a big boy right there, man. It's probably 30 years old too.
That was fun as hell.
That was so much fun, dude. Oh my God.
I can't believe I'm holding this thing in my hands right now.
This is a full-on apex predator.
Getting out to this place has proven to be incredibly difficult. And we've learned that these Taimen, they're equally as difficult to bring in. It seems fitting.
All right, let's let this guy go. It goes.
Yeah!
Woo! Yeah!
Nice one, B.
I cannot believe that just happened.
I'm speechless right now. I don't even know what to say. We're incredibly lucky that this trip played out the way that it did. So many different things could have gone wrong. There was a lot of things that did go wrong, but we were able to push through and prevail. We had an incredible experience hanging out with these Mongolians. Catching Taimen, that was the icing on the cake, though.
It is an incredible honor to be with all of you out here. And this is such an incredible experience for all of us. And just much respect. Thank you guys so much for everything that you've done for us. These Mongolian people, they are just the salt of the earth. They're some of the greatest, friendliest, happiest people. It's gonna be really sad, actually, to say goodbye.
The language barrier is insurmountable, except for the fact that people are people. I've really formed some friendships here.
You can't spend weeks into the wilderness with people and not have some type of a friendship develop between them.
And thank you for being just the baddest I've ever met.